Then check this out.
Hello guys, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can create a structure for dynamic PHP website. Using this approach, I have created myself like classified ads website years ago when I started learning PHP. So let's get into it, and I will start everything from the very scratch so you see everything from the very beginning. I will be even typing HTML. So let's start by going to our local C and go into XAMPP and into htdocs. And in this htdocs directory, I will create one folder. Create new folder, and I will call it site. And I will be using Notepad++, and as you see here on Notepad++, I have opened empty page. Let's start by typing basic HTML, and this will be doc type, okay, and HTML, and next tag will be HTML, as you know guys. Then straight away we will close this HTML tag, and then under HTML tag, obviously there is head tag. And I will be importing stylesheet to follow rules of web development, to not mix the code and not write inline CSS. I will write it in separate file as well, so you will see straight away how I'm importing or how I'm storing like style when I'm using this approach. And this is not object-oriented programming approach. However, I could create object-oriented programming approach of development as well. And in head, we are typing title tag, because this is one of mandatory tags as well. So it is in head tag. And then obviously we have body tag. Okay, body opening tag and body closing tag. And so guys, this is very, very basic structure of our site. And what we will do next is, in title I can write, this is my PHP site. However, this could be dynamic as well. And after this video, I think you will be able already to figure out how to make titles of your pages dynamic as well by writing these scripts. So next thing what we will do is we will separate page in three parts. However, you could separate it even in more parts if you would want for your site, but I will separate in three parts, because when you are creating dynamic websites, you separate page. Main thing is kind of you are doing like frameworking, you are creating a frame, you have a pretty good idea in your head what kind of website will it be. But anyway, all websites have header and footer, so at the very top I will use HTML5 tag, which is header. And this is not the same as head, guys. This is header tag, if you didn't know. And here I will simply type in like h1 tag or heading 1 tag, and I will close it down, and I will write this is header, like for example this is header. And in header we could add like one more tag for navigation, like nav opening tag and nav closing tag, okay? And this will be kind of for navigation, and in navigation we could create like an ordered list of some links, like for example an ordered list, because an ordered list is very easy to add style to. And so li and li, and if you didn't know guys, actually I will add unsort tag as well, href, and for now I will leave it blank. And I will close it. And say, let's say we will have 4 pages or 5 pages. So this is 1, 2. And if you didn't know guys how to duplicate in Notepad++, so you go at the beginning of the lines and click Ctrl and D, D, D. So you are copying and pasting. It's like Ctrl, D, 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 and that line where is your cursor, that will be duplicated. So here, first page about. Second, let's say, will be like products. Third could be like blog or whatever. It doesn't really matter. I'm going to show you how you can create dynamic pages with dynamic contents. That's why I'm only doing this particular tutorial. So you have, for new guys who have never coded in PHP, so you have a starting understanding how PHP dynamic language works. And in this case I will be using variable variables from URL, and I will show you how what I mean in a second. So next page, let's call it, so it will be contact. So let's leave it at 4 pages. I don't want 5 pages. So pretty much idea will be the same. So this will be header section. Then next section we could leave in simple div, like div, and we could give it ID and call it content simply. This particular div ID we call content, okay? And we will close this div at the very big end after, and in this div we will write simple h3 tag, okay, h3, and we will say content, content, okay? And at the bottom, at the very bottom, we will have footer, and this is as well HTML5 tag, footer opening and footer closing tag. So, and here I will simply use paragraph tag, and I will write this is footer, and that's it, because that doesn't really matter what I'm writing there. So what we will do next is we will add style sheet in our head section. Straight under title we will add style sheet, which I will create in a second, and we type link, type is equal and rel is equal, and this is actually, guys, how I work. That's why I always write these attributes. Type is like text forward slash CSS relating style sheet, and href will be, we will locate it, I will show you a bit later. But now let's save this file as index.php file in our site directory which we created. So let's click here save, and now we go to this PC and go to local C. This is like C directory, guys, at the top, as you know, where is exam directory, and in htdocs directory is our site directory where we will store our file. So let's go into this site and let's store it as index.php file. So let's save it and let's run this run in Chrome, as I'm using Chrome. And here at the beginning, note that here at the beginning is file forward slash c. Make sure that you always, whenever you are developing locally, and I am using XAMPP environment, and if you don't know, guys, what is XAMPP, watch my other videos where I'm explaining you what is XAMPP server. So here at the very top, you just before your folder's name, which is site, in this case, in my case, all this you simply delete and you write localhost, okay, and hit enter, and then your page will be looking normally like it would look if you are going to host it. So localhost forward slash and your directory's name, and in our directory, you know, there is index.php file, and as you know, guys, index file is always the first file which any system will read first. That's why we created index file where everything will start working in our scenario. And as you say, we have here header, we have this navigation, and this navigation will be in header. This will be top part of our site. And then we will have content, and content will be dynamic place. Whenever we will be clicking any of the links, content will be actually changing. It will be different content, and it will be calling content from outside. And then it's footer. Footer is the same, as you know, guys, for pretty much all websites all around the world. However, we could change dynamically here content in header and footer as well, guys. And I added only one column on content. However, you could add another column here in your content and change it dynamically as well. For example, sidebar. If, for example, you would have in about a sidebar, in products you don't have sidebar, so you could call it only in about us page and don't call it in products page. But let's keep it for later a little bit. Now we are going to add style to this. So let's go back to our folder where we were in XAMPP, like, okay, XAMPP htdocs. And in this site, we will create another folder, which we will call style, because usually you separate style from all other files. In style, you are storing your images of your website, your style sheets, and so on and so forth. So I create usually in this site another folder which has name style. And then we open Notepad++, and in Notepad++, let's create a new file. and this file I will write for body so we can see that the CSS works. That's what I as well always do. I write like background is red simply. So we see straight away that this style sheet works if it's included. Okay, background red. So let's save it in style directory and let's save it as core.css, and this will be kind of main style sheet for all our site. However, for different sections you could create another style sheets and include them only when they are needed, whenever your pages are loading. So, but I will, for this small site, I will create only one core style sheet. So save it, and now we will import it. And as you remember, I had this href or href. And here to import it, as you know, our index file, this particular index file, we need to go into style and to into core. So we simply write here style /core.css. So we are now importing our style sheet. So let's save this. Let's go back to our browser and let's refresh this page, and this page is red at the moment. This means that our style sheet works. And I will do offset rules. I will remove all margins and paddings as well by using like global offset rules. Straight away in style sheet at the very top, it is star sign, opening bracket and closing bracket. And here we will say simply margin, this is to zero, so it removes all default margins and all default paddings, so I can add only my margins and paddings, which I've margin to zero and padding as well to zero. So it will remove all default margins and paddings from all HTML elements. So if we go back now, refresh, as you see now everything looks nicely, neatly, and there's no margins and paddings which are not needed. So let's do a quick styling. So let's remove this background because we don't need pretty much that background. And let's have a look at our page. So here we have header. Let's style a little bit header. Let's put it kind of dynamic. Let's put it in width. Like I will apply straight away to header because there is normally one header tag only on page. And I will go with 100%. Okay, and float left. And I will give it a padding, like for example, padding top. Let's say I will give it 20%, 20 pixels. I will give right 0, bottom about as well. Let's say 20 pixels. Okay, and left I will leave 0. Okay, and let's give it some ground and let's give it blue, whatever it is. However, I don't like it, but it's okay, because in this video we are just, I'm just trying to show you how it all works. So we have this header area, and now let's do footer green. Let's do the same with footer. So to copy this, just first add this cursor below this. So click it like this, and like I said in Notepad++, to copy and paste everything, like in this case you can do Control D. So I copied header, so instead of header I will write now footer. Okay, and it will as well will be 20, 100% in width. It will be floated left, its padding top and bottom will be 20 pixels, but I will make it gray. Okay, gray. I'm not using any hexadecimal colors in this video. I'm using again native colors. So let's refresh it. And as you see guys, now we have footer, we have content area, and we have top header. Okay, and header you can add logos, you can add many other things, but let's add some styling to this particular navigation, so we see it better. So we see those links, let's float them simply so they look neater and nicer. So as you see, nav ul, however, nav ul li, let's go with nav ul li, and let's go, I will access him straight in nav ul li and a. So I straight away will remove list style to none. okay, float left, okay, and now let's add some style to links itself, like so nav ULLIA. And I'm doing just quick styling, guys. You can do styling however you want, but this is just for purpose of doing a very quick styling. So I will remove text decoration to none, text decoration none, display them block, so they are block level elements, not inline level elements, float left. Okay, and I will give them padding as well. Padding, I will give them top padding, let's say top and bottom padding 5 pixels, and left and right padding I will give them 15 pixels. Okay, and let's save this and let's go back to our page, refresh now, and as you see, actually I will change color to white. Okay, color will be white or FFF. Okay, shortcut is FFF, as there are all 6 FFFs. So we now have pages, 6 pages, and as you see, if I click about products, nothing is really changing. But what we'll be doing here, whenever someone will click about a page, we will display content from about page. Whenever someone will click products page, we will display content from products page, and we will do this all dynamically. So let's start with about us or home page. Let's create one more link for home page. Let's go back to our index file and let's duplicate one more, and very top one will be home. Home index.php, and this will be always home page as well. So next one is what you could add. Next one is index.php. We could copy this, copy, control V, and where is about, we write question mark about. We are adding variable about here, as you see, guys. And in all links we will do the same, copy, and you can add any variables, whatever names you want. I'm just adding them, so about is about, so it makes sense, guys. In products we will add not about, but we will add products, and this will be blog. Okay, and to contact we will add href contact instead of about. Contact. Okay, now we have 4 links. So if we go back, I will show you what is happening, guys, there. So let's open this page, and if we click on home, you see we are in index page. Make look at this very top, at the URL, how it's changing. If we click on about, we are getting this variable about. If we click on products, we are getting variable products. If we click on blog, we are getting variable blog. If we click on contact, we are getting contact. Now, depending on what variable will be displayed there, we will be changing dynamically content on its site. As you see here, where is content? Go back to our page. But before we start, actually, we could remove all, we could cut site, because normally you would cut this particular site into small pieces. And I will show you how to do this. So, as you see, we have top part of website, which is all header. However, you could cut only this, and you could cut header separately, and you could cut footer separately, and you could cut very bottom part separately. But to keep it simple, I will cut header with head section of this site with header section and put it in separate file. So how to do it is, we cut this, we open a new file, we paste all this code in there, and what we do next, and this means that after we have this header and navigation only in one place on our site, all the time, at all times we will have it on one place. Then we will go back to our directory, and here in our directory, site main directory, we will create another folder which we will call includes. Includes. Okay, and in this includes we will store those files which are dynamic and which we can call whenever we need to call them. So what we do is we save this file as header or head, you can call it however you want, in includes header.php. okay, that will be header, very top part, it includes navigation and everything. So let's save it, and now we go back to index file, and now we will need to include it in instead, because we need to include that back in our web. And to do this, we use include like statement. We write their PHP opening tag, and then we say include, and we include like this includes header.php includes / header.php. Okay, and we close PHP tag at the very end, because this is kind of includes header.php, because we are including this header file. So let's save it, let's go back to our site, let's refresh it, and as you see, nothing has changed. But if you think that it could change, so let's remove this includes to include only. Okay, and now if we go back, we refresh this page, you see there is warning. This is warning, there's file to open stream, there's no such file on line 1. And if we go back now to include this and add s back, we save this and go back to our site, we refresh it, and you see everything works fine. So we just included all this top part, so we have less code, and this particular code we for all our site we can manage in one place from now on. And we can call this header whenever we want, and we can remove this header whenever we want. However, normally you wouldn't remove header, you would take like navigation and you would separate from this one file navigation on another include, because then you could remove from some pages navigation and then you can include it whenever you want on other pages. But in this way, I'm showing just a whole picture how it works, so you can after operate yourself, and if you want something, just ask me in questions in comments under this video. So let's go back now and we will do the same part with all footer here. So let's cut it, let's open new file, let's paste it in new file, let's save it, and let's save it as well in includes, and we will call it footer.php. Okay, let's save it. And now we go back to our index file, and I will just quickly copy this, put it underneath of my site, and here I will, what I will do is in includes, instead of header, we are including footer. Okay, footer.php. And if we save now, we go back to our site, we refresh, we see that nothing has changed really here. And now we will take control of content, okay? And for content, we can do the same thing. We can create how many? We can create 4 additional pages, like or 5 additional pages, which would change depending on which button is clicked. Okay. For example, so let's close this footer because we will not be using it anymore, and we can close this. Actually, let's leave header open. Core, let's leave open for now. Actually, I will not be writing any more CSS. Let's open another file and let's say this is about us page, and on this page you can write anything. You can write PHP, you can write HTML, and you can write simple text, because this already content will be displayed in content area here, in content area. And I will show you how to do this. Because here in content area, we will be writing another PHP, like we will be opening PHP tag and we will be closing PHP tag. And here we will write PHP script, which will be including content depending on which page is called. Okay, and to do this, as you see, we have here variables. For about us page, we have about variable. For products page, we have products variable. For blog, we have blog variable. For contact us, we have contact variable. Okay, and to do this, we write PHP, like we write if. At first we can write for if is set brackets, and here we say variable or dollar sign underscore get square brackets, as you see, and here we write about. Okay, if about variable is set in variable, we can echo out something. Echo, let's say this is about page. Okay, or this is about. Let's leave it this is about. So let's save it. Let's open back. Let's refresh, and now let's click about, and you see this is about, but we don't want to echo out anything because we don't want to write script. We want to keep about this page content separately. That's why I told you to create another file, and this is about this page, and all HTML and everything will be located here. So we will save this particular file as well in includes, and or you could create another folder, pages, let's say, or however you like, but I will add it in includes as well, and then I call it about.php. okay, so all about page content will always be in one file. If I am requiring something for about this page in database, it will be here, so it will be all coming here, so I know that if I open in my the style structure includes about page, so all content for about this page is in this one file, guys. It is separated and it is dynamic, and it will get called whenever someone will click about page on site. As you see, if I go products, it's not called. If I click content, it's called, but we are not calling it now at the moment. We need to call to go back. Instead of this echo, we need to write include statement again. We need to write include the same as this copy, so we will put here control V, but we will be including not header.php but about.php. That's correct, guys. If we save now and we go back, we refresh this, you see this is about us page. And if we open again in Notepad++, this is about us page, we can like make a lots of these control D. So let's make a lot of this content. Let's save in this particular about page, and if we go back, refresh, as you see, there is loads of content. We can write anything, HTML, CSS, whatever you want to this content now. As you see, products, blog, contact, nothing's happening, and about is a lot of content. And similar way, we just continue with all other pages on our index page. And as you see, we have very viewable and easy to preview like content, and easy to work with. It is not hard to, and we don't need to read tons of content at the same time. And now we are separating out, like about this content is on this page now, and let's create for products page. Okay, and for products we can as well, we are creating a new file, and we are saying this is a products page, and let's save this in our includes directory, in our as products.php. You can call it however you want, but I am calling to make sense. So products.php, and I go back in here and I say else if. Okay, for example, I will paste it, I have one too much. Just let's close it. Else if is set get products now. Products in variable, as you understand, as you remember, guys. Now if we click products, if this is selected, then we want to display products page, then we include simply this control copy, and here we go here, and we include not about, but we include products. Okay, let's save it and let's check this out now. Let's refresh. And as you see, about this page, we have about this page content. In products page, we have this is products page. And for blog on contact page, we do exactly the same. We just continue writing this else if statement. And let's say close this and close this. And now let's create for blog and for contact page. Two pages, like this will be blog. This is blog page. Let's save it. Okay, let's save it blog.php, and now I will create straight away one more. This is contact page, and I will save it as well as contact.php, contact.php, and I will save it. And now I will import them depending on whenever they are called. So I just copy this, control copy, I paste it here, Control V. So else if it is set like blog, I will be importing blog page. Okay, this is includes. I will be including Control copy here, blog.php, blog.php, and the same applies to Control D. I will create else if is contact. I will be including contact.php page, and else if nothing is included, or else for index page we could write something like this, guys. I will show you. Control V, not else if, but else we simply else if is set nothing. If nothing is set, this means that there is no variable, like with index page. As you remember, if you click index, there is no variable, there is empty. So we are saying else if it is empty, we can include homepage content. Yes, we can include create homepage content as well. So let's create content for homepage as well, or you could write homepage for content directly here in index.php file, but let's create homepage content separately. Okay, this your home. Ah, no, home, this is not home.php. we are just saying here home.php, and we will create this file as well. And here new file, you are home, this is home content. Okay, let's save it as home.php. now in includes in includes, let's save it as home.php, and let's save it. And now let's go back to our site, and if we click on home, nothing happened. Let's go have a look where is our mistake, because this is happening quite fast. So else, or we can write simply else without all this. Actually, to tell the truth, we can write simply else, because as you know, guys, this could be else, as in else if statements. We can write else, simply include homepage, includes dot home.php, home.php. Let's save it, let's go preview it. Home, as you see, you are home, this is home content, V content, because I'm working fast. But this is, yes guys, as you see, pages work very fast, because every time they don't need to reload. We are actually every time loading only content, and that is the reason why these pages work so fast. And this is dynamic content, where you are not reloading header, where you are not reloading footer every time you are clicking a button. You are reloading only content of the site. And like I said, now in these pages, whenever you go back into your structure, into includes, like I said, you could add these not in includes, but say pages, and your pages could be in separate folder in your like site. Like here you could create pages, and you could add those pages, and then now you have access to every single page in easy way. You want homepage content, you just come edit with Notepad, and you have only homepage content, and it's clear. And you here you can write CSS, you can write HTML, you can write PHP, whatever you want, JavaScript, and add it to your website. So yes guys, I didn't go much into styling, but if this video was helpful to you, leave a like, subscribe. If you have more questions, ask in comments, guys, and see you in my video.